Well, a very good morning, ladies and gentlemen. And on behalf of Transient Holdings, I take great pleasure to welcome each one of you who joins us this morning in spite of your busy schedules. We are a global company providing most favored mobile communication products. And a few months back, April 2017, we started off with Techno Mobile's India journey with the launches in three states that include Punjab, Rajasthan, and Gujarat. And with the success stories, today we're here in your state to create yet another milestone. This is Anish Kapoor, the CEO of Techno and Infinix Mobiles, to please address the gathering and to take us through his presentations on the company and the products that we're going to be shortly launching in the state today.
So I'll just quickly take you through what Transient Holdings stands for, and so a small 4-5 slides which will help you understand what we do, where all we are present, and so on and so forth. So to introduce, I think we started our journey around 10 years back, and there are three key things which you see on your in front of you. We are probably the seventh biggest shipper shipment. We are probably the seventh biggest in terms of shipment in the world right now. But we are not very vocal about it. So in 2016, we sold close to 80 million devices. We are probably the biggest in Africa. We have more than 40% market share. We have more than 40% market share in sub-Sahara countries in Africa. And till now, we have shipped more than 246 devices. So we have close to 246 million subscribers or people who have used our phones till now. The legacy or what we stand for or what are the key things. So there are a lot of companies which are coming in, but to tell you more about it, we are not a transactional company. We have done a lot of investment in terms of R&D, manufacturing, and other stuff. So what you see here right now, we have close to 3 R&D centers. We also have a design tier. We have 3 manufacturing units. Right now, mainly focusing on China and one in Ethiopia as well. We have 5 repair factories, which essentially focuses on the service part of it. Service is very integral to what we how we work, and you will see there are close to 1500 odd touch points across the world right now, which we have. And obviously, the biggest strength, we are a very strong team of 15,000 plus people who are working in this group. Just a snapshot of how the journey went till now. We started, as I said, in 2006. We started with Itel in 2007. We started Africa operations in 2008. 2010 essentially was the big year when we became the top 3 brands in Africa. 2011 was all about the dual SIM space. So we were the number one in the dual SIM space. 2012, we launched Infinix, which is essentially focusing on online, and we have launched in India as well. 2013 was the smartphone journey for us. So all the brands, Itel, Infinix, and Techno, we started doing smartphones. 2015 was, so we ventured into, after 6 p.m. the live starts. So was the launch. 2016 was the major year for us when we started our journey in India. So we started our journey with Itel, and 2017, here we are. We have started launching other brands as well. So we saw a launch of Techno in the initial part of 2017, around April, when we started with 3 states. Then we went on to launch Infinix and Spice as well. We have 4 brand names under Transient Group. And so Itel, as I told you, we started our journey. And probably many of you will already know we are the number 2 in India right now in terms of volumes. And Spice is something which we have just started 2 months back, and we are doing extremely well. Techno, we are here for Techno. So we started our journey with 3 states. Now we are expanding in our phase 2 to another 12 states. So we'll be covering close to 15 markets in this space. And Infinix obviously is the right now the online specific brand which focuses on the online space only. So I think coming to the main part for which we all of us are here, which is all about Techno. What do we want to do with Techno? What Techno is probably the most important brand for us, and probably what we want to do is something which comes out in this vision statement. I think objective for us in India is obviously we want to be most respected and lovable brand, so that's a standard part of it, because I think everything we do, consumer is the core of it. So hopefully consumers adapt, and what we have seen till now, I think the response has been phenomenal. And obviously, so one of the key objectives which we carry as we go along in this journey is by 2018 we would want to be amongst top 5 brands in the offline space. So that's what we want to do. That's our Techno as a brand, what we want to achieve with Techno. So that's what we are looking for. So as I said, expanding footprints. So 3 markets we started our journey. So this was initial markets. We have covering another 12. So we are here in Chennai today and to cover the Chennai come today. So coming to this part, I think so that was all about what Transion stands for, what are the brands which we are running with, and what we have done so far in Techno Mobile. I think to give you a flavor of what we want to do and probably take you through the product part. So this is the probably something which will be pretty exciting for all of you. So we are a global organization. So that's the easier part for all of us is we have a portfolio running. We have a great market share in Africa, and probably there are characteristics which are pretty similar. But yes, and we can just take the products from there and launch in India. What we did actually is, and probably have taken a lot of time to launch here, and probably that's why we are a bit late in September. We actually took a lot of time to understand the consumers. So we actually reached out to more than 2,000 people to understand what are the preferences, what are the key pain points, what are the challenges. So what you see on the screen is what we have taken out of it. So these are the key things which came out, what they want to, what these consumers want. So what are the consumers who are using those phones? So these phones essentially, these guys are essentially young, value seekers. Probably phone has become an extension of their personality. They're addicted to their phones. They want to attract and leave an impression. So they want a very beautiful looking phone. And probably the lives have changed. And the normal office time does not end at 6 p.m. After 6 p.m. the life starts. So the pain points and changing usage pattern, what you see is what we got out of these people whom we spoke to. So we are talking about normally what happens is from your morning office time 6 till 6 p.m. essentially what do you do? You normally do your check your mails, you do your office work, you do office chats, probably some video calls if it is required, your banking, your LinkedIn. I think LinkedIn is everybody does that. Scanning few documents if it is so required. But once you are done with that and once you're back from office, then what happens? So then the life starts for most of the people who are actually the consumers. Your typical 18 to 35, 40 people. So that's where they play, probably not 40, but yes, the 35 definitely. So then the WhatsApp, Facebook, your all social media, everything starts happening. So they want to go out, party, click a lot of photographs. So that's what they want to do, and probably the day extends till midnight. So that's the changing usage pattern, what we saw. And what is the experience? So right now, we meet a very basic level of performance. Obviously, most of the phones, and there are a lot of phones which talk differently. Battery is a huge challenge, which we came out with. And images, so photographs, a lot of photo cameras. Photographs are very good in the day, but as we go into the evening, you have challenges. It's blurry, not very clear. So the 6 p.m. to midnight, the challenges are plenty, because while you're on the way back, your battery tends to start dying and you're wondering what to do. And so in fact, when you're very social, so you also are looking at how the phone looks in your hand. So these are things which people really want to do. So what we thought, since we understand the current usage patterns, so what are the problems we should be looking to resolve with the phone series which we want to launch? So we thought, okay, one of the key things which is coming because of the changing usage pattern is what we do 6 p.m. to midnight. So low light images, so we are talking about one of the cameras as the key guiding thing in our whole portfolio. So best in class night camera performance, that's what we are talking about here. Battery, yes, obviously is a challenge, so bigger batteries are required, so that's being done. Quality of how the phone looks like, so sleekness of the phone, whether the phone is good looking or not, yes, that's what we want to resolve. And obviously we're talking about fast charging, so even if you have come back and you want to go for a party, you have 30 minutes, 40 minutes, you'll see with the fast charging your phone is charged up to 60% to 70%. So, and obviously there's one more thing which I think everyone, every mobile company and everybody does is UI, the skin on the phone. So we thought the optimized skin which we put, how does it enhance the value proposition for the consumers rather than just the skin which is probably showing on the phone. So these are the things which we thought of, and that's why we created the series which we're going to talk about. So this, we're talking about Pixelix technology, which essentially is focusing on the camera problem, the night camera problem which we have. So we thought with Pixelix, what are the things which we're going to do? So we are talking about four core things here. We are talking about a front dual screen, dual LED. So it's not dual LED, we have a front LED and a screen flash. So what it helps is you can click a much better and brighter picture in the night when you take those selfies, when you're out. So because there are two flashes, one is on the screen and one is on the LED. The whole algorithm. So right now there are a lot of phones and you have got that beauty mode which helps you become very nice. But what we have done is, we've actually, after the study and I think what the feedback we got, we actually become extremely fairer, or probably the overall quality of pictures do not come out very well. So I think what we did was the algorithm which has been built, the camera, you will see the quality of pictures are very suitable to the Indian skin tone. So it is made according to the Indian skin tone. So that's one of the things which we have done. We talk about cutting edge camera. Obviously, we have a great aperture. You will see in the presentation as I go forward with the product. Probably one of the only brands which is using great lenses, and even the front cameras have 2.0 aperture ratio, which is probably one of the best in the class. And last but not the least, the most important part of it is the quad LED flash. So normally you see whatever phones which talk about great cameras, they have one LED flash. For night pictures, we have actually put four LEDs in the back flash. So you have four LEDs in the back, which enhances the light and clicks great, amazing pictures. So these are things which we did to enhance the camera. I think a lot of people from the camera guys were there and people were there clicking pictures, they'll find these phones extremely exciting. Now let me talk about iOS. So this is skin. So obviously all our phones are based on the latest Nougat. So we are using the latest Nougat. No, so 7.0 is what we run on. So what this skin does for you? So one is it is pretty light. It is not a heavy skin, but I think a few things which we learned and we got as insights, we try to build in this. So what it does is you will split screen. So split screen is essentially we all want to do multitask. We have WhatsApp open most of the time, or any other chat box, or then you have Facebook. You want to chat to multiple people, you want to watch a video and do a chatting, so you can do that. You have a multi-screen option. WhatsApp mode, this is actually very exciting. So when you are running low on battery and you don't want too much data to be consumed, we have actually put a WhatsApp mode, which means all other data will cut off and only WhatsApp will get the data. So that means your data consumption, a typical Android phone consumes a lot of data in the background. So this takes care of that problem. While on low battery as well, you can continue to chat. Freezer, I think one of my favorite apps and I keep using it. If I do randomly ask you how many apps you have, probably you'll say 30, 40, 50 on your, because you keep downloading certain things you like, but you don't use it. And the beauty of Android is it keeps consuming data at the back end. So what we have done here is, it's a freezer. So whatever app you're not using and you use probably once in 15 days, 10 days, 20 days, then you can just put it on freezer. So all data is cut off, but it is there in your phone. And probably you use your WhatsApp, WeChat, or your LinkedIn, Facebook, 4, 5, 6 apps, Ola, Uber, whatever it is. So these are, you keep using it, but all other apps are there in the freezer. A great app, I think very, very useful. Outdoor mode. Outdoor mode typically is used, so while you're coming out of the sun and you're trying to see something on the phone, you try and put it on the full brightness because it's difficult to view. And once you do that, the tendency is you tend to forget it. And then the battery drain starts because the consumption of battery becomes the most when you are on the maximum level of brightness. So you have one click, which is the outdoor mode. So when you're going out, you want to use it. After 15 minutes, it will auto disconnect. It will come back to the natural thing, so which you're using indoor. So that takes care. So whatever, as a human, we tend to forget, we are trying to build it in the phone. And I think all of us, video chat is probably something which has become a norm after the data has become so cheap. I think, but video chat has its own set of issues. So you don't like your face on the video chat. That's a typical thing which you see. And I definitely don't. So I don't know about you, but I don't. But what it does is actually, it helps you adjust the brightness. So even if you're in a dark space right now, if you're sitting at the back and you want to do a video call, suddenly you can adjust the brightness and your face becomes pretty visible and it looks as natural as it gets. So a great thing to adjust on the video chat. And I think your people who use it or kids will love it because it helps you look much better, even in the bad light. Last but not the least, I think there are multiple other features, but I am just trying to highlight 6, 7, which are key things for me, for us right now on the iOS or the skin which we want to use. This is a voice assistant. So it's a micro intelligence kind of thing, wherein so your phone is right now blanked out, and you want to know the time. So you double tap, it'll tell you the time. This is the time. You again double tap, it'll tell you the weather information. If you again double tap, it'll tell you what is the alarm time for you. So things which matter, which we can use in our daily life, all those things which we have tried to cover basis the insights which we got. So these are the things which we have done with the phone. And this is how the skin, the iOS which we talk about, is optimized for consumer usage. Going back to the third point, the third pain point, which was essentially talking about design. Yes, we've got big batteries, but we don't want to be bulky, we want to look good. So all of us want to look good, so is the phone, right? So we are trying to take that inside and make sure the phone looks good. It's pretty slim. You will see even with a 4000 mAh battery, the thinness is pretty low. And obviously we have narrow bezels and small little things. Now the speakers are at the bottom instead of the back. You don't have to put the phone back. It's right there. You can put it and keep talking. And there's a front fingerprint sensor, which is the front fingerprint sensor and button. So essentially you will see most of the phones come with the back fingerprint sensors. In our case, which what we have done is we've actually put it on the front so that it is easier to use. This actually is it's exceptionally good thing which has been done, and it is coming to use for me right now. I think because as Indians we are pretty used to eating with our hands, we love it. All of us do, right? So even if you have oily fingers, but what it does is fingerprint is not an issue. With even so, our fingerprint are made with sapphire glass button, so even if it is oily, it'll still recognize the fingerprint. So another small thing, but taken care for India. So these are things which we have done. So now I'll take you to the product portfolio. So these are things which came in terms of innovation, what we have done as a technology, as the skin or the software which we are using on top of standard Nougat. I think to start with, let me play AV here. I think, can I have AV please? Okay. i7, what we have done is, so we talked about camera as our core proposition and night selfies and the beautiful looking woman was, all girls was there, I think they will love it. So 16MP night selfie camera, which is really really good, but obviously dual flash, which I talked about. So dual flash, you will see the screen flash and the front LED flash. I was talking about the wide 2.0 aperture ratio, so which actually helps you with the great pictures. And we have a 5P lens, screen and LED flash, which I talked about. Rear camera is 13MP. So 13MP rear camera, 16MP front camera. And the rear camera also has a 2.0 aperture size with 5P Larkin lens, and the quad LED flash which I was talking about. So four LEDs to help you take clearer pictures. The obviously when you have a great camera, what else you have? You have a 4GB RAM with 32GB ROM, which is expandable up to 128GB, and with a 64-bit octa-core processor. Display is 5.5 full HD screen, and we are talking about a LTPS display, which essentially is a low temperature polysilicon display. What it does is it helps you create those slim phones even with bigger batteries. And when I say 650 nits, it essentially is how the display ratio of the screen is, which on a typical phone is close to 400 odd. So we are talking about a great display and a great, very bright screen here. Battery, so we have 4000 mAh battery and supported by rocket charging. So we're talking about a fast charging with 2 ampere fast charging and 80% in 60 minutes. So anytime you have even some small whatever time you have, you can quickly charge your batteries. And as I said and I promised, I think one of the most slim phones you will see in this category. It is only 7.75 mm and metal unibody. Available in 3 great colors. I think all Indians, we love our gold, so gold is there. And obviously a fan of black is there. And space gray. So 3 colors to choose from. A great product with all the color varieties which we think are great, which are required for Indian market. So to summarize what i7 is, we have a 5.5 FHD display, 4+32, 16MP, 13MP rear camera. We have a 4000 mAh battery, rocket charging, anti-oil fingerprint. That's a standard thing for a fingerprint sensor. VoLTE and VLTE available, Nuga, metal unibody, and obviously 64-bit octa-core processor. So that tells you about the i7, which is the first phone which we are bringing to the market. The second is our mid-range series, which we talk about i5 and i5 Pro. So essentially the same phones with different memory. So front camera, again you will see 8MP naked selfie camera. And yes, the flashes are standard in every phone which we talk about. Same 2.0 aperture with 5P lens. Screen and LED flash, I said that is a standard thing which you put in all the phones which we have created here. Rear camera is 13MP with obviously 2.0 aperture and 5P lens and quad LED. So quad LED and the front dual flash becomes a norm for all the phones which we are going to launch right now, which we talk about. Display is again 5.5 HD with the great 550 nit ratio, and obviously battery is again a powerful 4000 mAh and has a rocket charging as well. At 8.05 mm, I think one of the very sleek looking phones. I think you'll get to know and get your hands on those phones, you'll love it. And metal unibody obviously. So two variants, as I said, we have i5 and i5 Pro. i5 essentially is 2GB plus 16GB, and i5 Pro is 3 plus 32. So two variants which we are launching, and we have 3 great colors. So you will see a black, sky black, and a champagne gold for i5 Pro, and a space gray and a champagne gold for i5. So gold is common, so everybody gets gold. That's what we want. i5 summarized again. I think I don't need to take you through it. I think it gets boring it after some time, but just to summarize and give you a sense of it, it is in one sheet. The third is i3 and i3 Pro. Again, we start with the camera. We have a great 8MP with again a 2.0 aperture ratio. Front flash and screen flash, I keep mentioning, it's the same. It's a standard thing which we have put in. Rear camera is again, so it's 8 plus 8 with 2.0 aperture ratio. And this also has a quad LED flash. So you'll not get a phone with a quad LED flash at this price point which we are going to announce, that's for sure. We have a great display. So even if it is a 5HD on-cell IPS, the nit ratio is still much better than most of the other phones you will see in the category. So it's much more brighter screen which we are talking about. Battery is 3015 mAh in this, and with a slimness of 7.9. And again, this is available in 2 variants. So we are talking about 2GB plus 16GB, and i3 Pro is 3 plus 16. Another addition in Pro is there's a fingerprint sensor also. So it's not only the memory variant, there's a fingerprint sensor which is also added into i3 Pro. So colors, so we continue with our gold journey. So we have two golds in this category. We have i3 Pro and i3 with champagne gold and luxurious gold, and space gray and champagne gold for i3. So you will find essentially a lot of colors which are available in each of the phones which you're launching. To summarize, 8 MP front, 8 MP back, you have a 3000 mAh battery, 16 GB ROM, 2 GB, 13 GB, depending on the variant you want to pick up. Fingerprint for i3 Pro, 64-bit quad-core processor, and VoLTE built-in enabled. That's a standard thing now. The pricing, I think the best part of this is the pricing. I think very, very aggressively, very, very competitively priced. We are talking about i3 at only a price of point of 7990, and i3 Pro, which actually is a 3 GB variant, 3 plus 16 is 9990. You have i5 and i5 Pro, which starts at 11490 and 12490 respectively. And the i7, which is the 4 GB, 32 GB variant, and probably the one of the most sleekest phones you will see, is at 14990. These are the consumer prices. These are the prices on which we are launching these phones, and already be selling and getting some great response. One of the things which actually puts whenever there's a new brand which comes in, so there are a lot of things which are talked about. So, as you said, we are global. We are already in 58 countries, and to make sure customers understand what we are bringing to the market, this is a very initial launch proposition or limited offer which we are bringing, which is our brand promise, which is 151. We are talking about a 100 days replacement, which is unheard of in the market. We are also saying 50% cash back. If you want to sell your phone and probably give your phone back and take another variant after 1 year, so you get 50% assured cash back. And if your phone is broken by chance, so one-time screen replacement is free. So very, very unique proposition and a great proposition for consumers. I think people will love it. So great phones, great capacity, great capability built in, and a great service promise which we are bringing to the market. And it is supported by 850 plus service centers. So just to give you, we have already a great service network, and which goes by the name of Palcare. So we are already there in 850 plus service points. So I think that's what we are doing, and that's what we're bringing to the market. And that's where I end this presentation. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Anish. So I isn't just an alphabet for us in the product. It is a symbol of attitude, confidence, power of individuality, and most of all, importantly, the power of India. The Generation I is ready to meet the world. And for now, may I like to call up on stage once again Mr. Anish Kapoor, Mr. Yuvraj Natarajan, CEO of Purvika Mobiles, Mrs. Kani Yuvraj, MD Purvika Mobiles, and Mr. Rajashekar, Modern Trade Head, Techno Mobiles, to please join us in the dais. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the moment has arrived, the moment for which we've all been waiting for, and it's a moment of pride for each one of us over here. So please join me forward to create some excitement as we present to you the launch of the Techno Mobiles for the first time in the state of Tamil Nadu. So may I request you all to please put your hands together, flash your cameras, as we have the launch happening in Chennai today.
I'm from Hello City, we have a Portal TV. First question to a local partner. Do you have any plan for local promotions in specific branch?
No, I don't get you. I don't.
are you planning for a promotion with, in particular a local branch, like any particular branch of your Purvika outlet? Are you planning to have any promotional activity?
For Techno, right?
For Techno. Yeah, of course, this is for Techno.
So actually today we are having a separate launch in our showroom. Okay, so there's a big launch is going to happen in our store, where all our RSMs, ASMs, my store managers, most of the staff and lots of customers are coming. So we'll have a mega launch now in the store level also. And we're doing lots of live demos in on most of the stores. And we'll have big displays of Techno products across our stores, so that the customers can come and experience it and they can get their products. And the products are really lovely.
Do you have a plan of opening any exclusive Techno sales outlet in Chennai?
I think we're just starting a journey. It's too early for us to look at that. I think when the time comes, or probably later in next year or sometime later, I don't know. Can't give you a timeline right now, but yes, right now our partner is Purvika and that's what we are going to focus on.